The Quincy Art Association has been in this town, in the old school building at 26 High School, for over 40 years as an association. Previously, it was the high school in this town. And its mission is to reach out to the community, to make art available to children and adults, to have several exhibits a year, and just raise the ability of the community to participate in the arts. We're under new leadership since the Arts Fest, and this is a very dynamic new leadership in charge of Quincy Art. We're eager to have new members, we're eager to have volunteers. You can get involved in myriad ways. We need a new membership coordinator. We're going to need a class coordinator. We'd like young people involved. We've reached out to the Quincy Public Schools through the mural project for the last 2 years. The high schools and the middle schools have created murals that we've displayed at the Arts Fest. And this year, all 11 elementary schools are doing murals related to an iconic children's book illustration. So we've offered free membership to the art teachers, including the Woodward School, and we'd love to be part of a real dynamic renaissance in Quincy of the arts. I grew up in Kansas City, and I went to the Kansas City Art Institute, which is probably famous for Walt Disney having gone there. And members of my family, my aunt was an artist, so I've been drawing since I was 5 years old. But I spent my career teaching both English and math at an alternative high school. But I always loved art, and we always, in my high school teaching experience, I always conducted an art elective for the students. So most artists you'll find have had it since childhood. They just grew up scribbling. I would guess I've been involved for about 20 years. I was briefly the vice president. I'm part of the exhibit committee. I helped teach classes there, sculpture, figure sculpture, portrait sculpture. And my friend and I, Chris Kreitman and I, conduct the life class, open studio, every Tuesday nights. Chris Kreitman has been a great friend of mine and a contributing member of Quincy Art for, I would guess, 20 years. He and I have, for the last 10, have coordinated the models that we hire for the open studio class. And he is an award-winning portrait artist and a landscape artist. His work is known all over Quincy, and I believe he recently won the DPW's poster contest for Clean Water in Quincy with a beautiful painting he did of Black's Creek. The Quincy Art Association's Open Studio Life class is a Tuesday night class that runs from 7 to 10. And it's not just for Quincy artists or Quincy Art Association members. Any artist can drop in and pay the $15 for the 3 hours that we run the class. And it has been going also for at least 18 years. And it was previously coordinated by Bill DiMattia, who ran it for at least the first 10 years. And he did a wonderful job of keeping that going. And Chris and I have done it at least the last 8 years. And we welcome artists to come from any community and join us for Tuesday night, 7 to 10 o'clock. We're going to have our first group show at the library in December. We'll hang the show on December the 2nd, and it should be open for the viewing public at about noon on Saturday, December 2nd. It'll run for the month, and it's comprised of artwork from our 20 artists, both portraits and the nude figure. We'll have a pretty good representation of both in all kinds of media, from pencil drawings, quick sketches, to, you know, paintings that have taken many hours. And some of our models allow photography, so we can take their photographs home and spend a lot of time making the kind of artwork we want to make. And you'll see some of that very detailed work at the December show. If you check around the area, there's not many art associations that do have an open studio where people can come in and draw the figure. I know Cohasset does and some others in the region, but ours has been in place, I said, for about 20 years, because In art school, the figure is the central discipline that an artist trains to become adept in his skills, even if they go on to become landscape artists. So in that vein, Quincy art has always valued the drawing from the figure and the portrait. As I said, we even have figure sculpture, portrait sculpture classes available. So in the new revival of realism in this country, which has a very strong new movement run by the Art Renewal Organization, drawing from the figure is still the premier training of an artist. We will have about 20 artists represented in this show, the first time I think some of them have ever exhibited. It's not often that a public space allows nude art. The Crane Library under Ann McLaughlin and under Megan Allen has always been open to that and very respectful of that, the importance of that. So some of the artists are as young as in their 20s and some are as old as me. And we have, some of us have been at this for 50 years and some have just joined within the last month. And you'll see a variety of styles. Some will be 15 minute sketches in pencil. And some will be in pastel, some will be in watercolor, some will be in oil paint, and it will be quite a good representation of the experience. Because our setup is, our format is a 3-hour single pose by a nude model, usually a female. And we have worked into that format after trying 15-minute poses and 5-minute poses and our artists are experienced enough that they like the long pose. And in some cases, we have a super long pose for a month where we hire a model who comes for 4 weeks in a row and we'll have a 12-hour pose with the art with the model. And that gives us a lot of time to do, you know, a lot of narrative painting and stuff like that. We have a regular spring art show at the library. I think it's called Spring into Art. It's moved around the calendar a little bit. It used to be in May. So that's our premier annual library show, and that's not just the life class. That's any medium, landscape, any subject that the artist wants to present. And I will just put in a plug for the Marina Bay Arts Affair, which is connected to Quincy, obviously. That's the first weekend in August, and that's always a big show. That's been going on for 20 years. And the huge event in Quincy art is the Quincy Art Fest in mid-September, which was a huge success this year. We had, 450 entries, $3,000 in prizes handed out, and we're continuing our fabulous fake category, which references a famous masterpiece in art, either to try to copy it exactly or to reinterpret it in a new way. So a lot of things going on in art in Quincy. I would like the patrons of the library to, when they come to the circulation desk, which is where the exhibit is, to notice that there's a lot of talented artists in Quincy. You've seen individuals portrayed there on a monthly basis. This is our first group show. And we would also like them to consider joining us on a Tuesday night. We're always in the recruitment mode. Come and join us on a Tuesday night. We'll have a good blurb on the history of the life class. We will have all the artists' names and their contact information. If the patrons would like to buy anything, the library doesn't allow us to sell anything or put a price tag in it, but they'll at least be able to contact the artist. Maybe they'll want a portrait commissioned because they'll see a lot of good portrait work there. And we really want them to just appreciate the level, the quality of art in Quincy. We want people to come on December 2nd is when the show opens. And we'll have a reception on Saturday, December 9th. I think it's 2 to 3:30. Well, the public is invited to come. You'll meet our artists, many of them, and possibly some of our models. I think some of them want to come. And we'd just like to have you come and enjoy it and join us on a Tuesday night.